Hello, esteemed faculty, staff, friends, family, and graduates. It is an absolute honor to have the opportunity to speak to you today. I would like to begin first by saying that under ordinary circumstances, I might shout, "Congratulations, we made it," and move on. Yet, I want to acknowledge the extraordinary circumstances under which I congratulate you today. This past year has been like no other before it. We experienced an ongoing global pandemic, a catastrophic winter storm, and amidst it all, heightened economic and racial injustice. Yet, in spite of the arduous path that lay ahead of us, we proved resilient. We crafted new paths where none had existed before, learned new virtual environments, and worked together as a team with the best faculty, staff, and university leadership in the country. We took canceled experiences and turned them into new opportunities, and we refused to give up, not on ourselves and not on each other. I don't know what each of your stories are, but I have a feeling that many may be a bit more non-traditional like mine. And if so, it's not only our stories that changed today, yet perhaps that of our entire families. I stand in front of you today as a first-generation graduate in my 30s, the daughter of two amazing teen parents, and the proud mom of two perfect little boys. Jack, my 7-year-old who loves math and science, and Sam, my 13-year-old who loves music, words, and also lives with severe autism. This day is yours. To each of you listening right now, no matter your story, know that you are here because of your brightly shining, beautifully resilient Commencement spirit. Today, I would like to leave you with one piece of advice. Go after the opportunities that you think you will never get. Doing so may completely change your life. I know it has mine. And on that note, I will now say congratulations to the University of Texas at Dallas graduating class of 2021. We made it.
Thank you all, family, friends, faculty, and staff, for supporting us through our journey at UT Dallas and for being here with us today. I'd like to start with a quote by Oren Harari. "The electric light did not come from the continuous improvement of candles." I really like this quote because it encourages us not to only try to improve what already exists, but to go beyond what we know to be true. Evolution via continuous improvement is great, but revolution and innovation are extraordinary. I believe that all of us, whether personally or professionally, have been told that is impossible or that is too challenging. We need to take a view that if what is possible is defined by what has been possible, then possibilities are inherently limited. That's why I challenge all of us, including myself, to go beyond the comfort of possibilities and the ordinary and strive to achieve the extraordinary, thus becoming true innovators, disruptive in how we do. I challenge us to go after what we truly believe in, but don't forget that belief without action is sure to yield nothing. So take actions driven by your beliefs, regardless of obstacles or stacked odds. In success, there is celebration. In failure, well, there's also celebration, because there's an opportunity to grow and try again. For instance, an entering MBA student has 5 years of professional work experience. I had just a tiny bit less. I had none. Yet, I set my goal to join one of the world's most prestigious consulting firms. Somewhat expectedly, I was met with strong skepticism. A few people even called me delusional. Nonetheless, after hours of preparation, community engagement, internships, and collaboration with other fellow students, I've achieved my impossible goal. This summer, I'll be joining McKinsey & Co. as one of their youngest associates. We have made the impossible possible and encourage future classes to achieve the same. And by we, I mean all of us, the class of 2021. We've gone through a global pandemic, the biggest movement for diversity and inclusion, a complete shift in the modality in which we work and we study, and yet we persevered. We succeeded. I hope that we continue to succeed and that wherever we go, we continue to be disruptive. Electric lights rather than better candles. And I truly hope that I will have the opportunity to engage with you again, this time in the C-suite. Thank you.
Hello, graduates. I am standing in the Eugene McDermott Library, a building that has been at the center of campus since the university's earliest days. We are gathered virtually to celebrate your hard work and dedication to get to this point in your academic journey. Obviously, this is not the manner in which you thought you would mark this significant milestone. I know that you would prefer to celebrate in person, so I invite you to return in August when we can offer a traditional ceremony. Commencement is an ideal time for reflection on the progress that has been made here at the university, as well as in your own pursuits. Before the pandemic so dramatically altered our plans, our spring 2020 commencement was to have focused on the university's 50th anniversary. Our three founders, Eric Johnson, Eugene McDermott, and Cecil Green, envisioned a university that would train top talent and serve the good of the North Texas region through research, education, the arts, and cultural programs. Our founders would be quite pleased and maybe even a little surprised at what has transpired in the 51 years of our existence. We are classified as a Carnegie R1 doctoral institution, one of only 131 in the nation. Forbes has ranked us as the number one best value among public universities in Texas. The Chronicle of Higher Education, before the pandemic, listed us as the nation's second fastest growing public university offering a doctoral level education. While the founders could take pride in the transformation of their startup research enterprise, I believe that they would be exceptionally proud of how the students, faculty, and staff at UT Dallas have managed in a year of unanticipated and dramatic change. Let me use the McDermott Library as an example. At one time, students lined up on the first floor to register for classes in person. Online registration would not be an option for years to come. And the surest way to locate the latest research articles or literary works was to visit the card catalog or consult with a librarian. Needless to say, this library has changed over the decades, yet it has remained essential to learning and research. Its evolution mirrors that of the university. Despite being closed for in-person use over the last 12 months, the McDermott Library has continued to support student and faculty needs in acquiring and producing knowledge. The adaptability of our library services is but one example of many of the resilience of our faculty, students, and staff. We sought new ways to connect with each other and in the process discovered new ways to teach classes and hold events. We have stepped up to give back, including donations of personal protective equipment to local hospitals and contributing to the funds to help students in need. Since March, our students, faculty, and staff have volunteered at the community vaccine site on our campus that is operated by the UT Southwestern Medical Center. Our current situation is not the only time in our history that this community and higher education as a whole has been challenged by circumstances beyond our control. In 2009, in a world dealing with threats to public health, financial markets in turmoil, and global political unrest, and does that sound familiar? Our graduates faced an uncertain future. Then, as now, they were entering fields that required creative solutions in a rapidly changing environment. As UT Dallas President David Daniels said in his commencement remarks that year, "Remember where you are from. At UT Dallas, we embrace the unknown, study it, and turn what we find into something that serves people and society." In other words, knowledge, and people with knowledge, will always be needed to meet the demands of our times. This is the role of a university, to benefit society by teaching students and developing intellectual capital. Graduates, it is your contribution to the future which inspires all that we do and all that we are. Your critical thinking and acquired knowledge have never been more needed by our world. So let me extend to you my heartfelt thanks for responding to this challenge, and most especially, thank you for choosing UT Dallas to earn your degree. Job well done, graduates. It is my fervent hope that your time at UT Dallas has been but a prelude to a lifetime of learning and wonderment. Remember, UT Dallas will always be your home. As alumni of this great university, you will always be welcome here. I sincerely hope that you will return often. And now, it is my privilege to introduce the Provost of the University of Texas at Dallas, Dr. Inga Musselman.
Graduates, families, friends, and UT Dallas students, staff, and faculty, welcome to the University of Texas at Dallas virtual commencement. Our graduation ceremony this spring celebrates your resilience and determination to reach this important milestone. You have helped to make UT Dallas a leading, multifaceted teaching and research university. Teaching and research, that's what we do best. At UT Dallas, teaching is a priority. We are awarding bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees in the fields of arts and humanities, arts, technology, and emerging communication, behavioral and brain sciences, economic, political, and policy sciences, engineering and computer science, interdisciplinary studies, management, and natural sciences and mathematics. Most of our students are Texans, and as a state-supported public university, that is appropriate. But we also have an important contingent of students from across the United States and from around the world. Our student body provides UT Dallas with diversity that is characteristic of world-class universities. Graduates, we are grateful for your continued patience during this most unusual time in our nation's history. Your class will forever carry with it the cachet of a community that united with singleness of purpose to help you achieve your academic goals. So again, welcome graduates, families, and friends. I now have the privilege of introducing my colleagues, the deans of our 8 schools, who wish to offer their congratulations. Enjoy the celebration.
Congratulations, you've reached your goal.
We applaud your perseverance,
your remarkable abilities,
your bright futures.
May you never stop learning,
and may your path be smooth.
You inspire us.
Congratulations. Join us for the ceremonies recorded especially for your school.
Congratulations to all of our graduating students. To say that this year has thrown challenges in your path is an understatement. You should all be extremely proud of your accomplishments. I have witnessed our students taking part in shaping our community through their dedication to service and intellectual inquiry. And I would like to take a moment of your time to let you all know how impressed I am by every one of you and how much I look forward to seeing what you do next. We have a number of students graduating with honors today. And before I move on to certifying the undergraduate degrees, I would like to offer a special recognition of those students. Among the programs with students graduating, we have the Service Honors Program, developed by the Office of Undergraduate Education, to recognize students whose contributions to the university community go beyond academic achievement. Specifically, to earn service honors, undergraduates must complete a minimum of 40 hours of volunteer service each semester during their time at UT Dallas and possess a minimum cumulative GPA of 3.25. Major honors in the disciplines: Latin honors, which are based on a 45-hour residency requirement and grade point average benchmarks set within each school. Cum laude honors are earned by the top third, magna cum laude by the top 15%, and summa cum laude by the top 5%. Collegium 5, which is UTD's 4-year honors program, from which students graduate with at least a 3.5 grade point average, 24 hours of honors-related work, and an honors capstone thesis or project. And Phi Kappa Phi, which is the nation's oldest, largest, and most selective all-discipline honor society. Congratulations to all of our graduates.
Today, we recognize and celebrate your dedication, hard work, and the glorious achievement of earning your degrees. We know you have gained a great deal of knowledge, but even more important, you have gained the ability to understand and apply that knowledge. We hope you will use that ability to understand, to pursue new directions, to acquire new knowledge, and to apply it wisely. I would also like to recognize the tremendous contributions, commitment, and sacrifices of the parents, families, and friends that help make this day a reality. Students succeed not only because of their own efforts, but also because of the support they receive from family and friends. So to our graduates and their families, congratulations, good luck, success, and best wishes for your very bright futures.
I have an exciting and meaningful responsibility during each commencement ceremony as the Dean of Undergraduate Education, which is to certify your degrees. Please stand up as you are able, and be sure your family and/or your friends are listening. It is now my honor.
It is now my honor
to certify the candidates for undergraduate degrees.
To certify the candidates who have completed all of their academic requirements and are entitled to receive their master's and doctoral degrees.
Dr. Benson, on behalf of the faculty,
I certify to you
that those candidates who have completed all of their academic requirements
are entitled to receive their respective degrees.
Are entitled to receive their respective degrees.
Thank you, Deans Murphy and Gonzalez. Now, by the virtue of the authority vested by law in the Board of Regents of the University of Texas System, I confer upon each of you the respective academic degree for which you have been recommended, with all the rights, privileges, responsibilities, and obligations appertaining thereunto, and I offer my sincere congratulations.
When I think about EPS and our students over the last year, the first word that comes to mind is resilience. How we adapt to challenges like the pandemic and the North Texas deep freeze highlights the salience of our disciplines. Our social and policy sciences guide discussions about how many and what type of regulations are optimal, how to address critical challenges of governance, how to best remedy inequality and injustice, how to create effective public services and reliable critical infrastructure, and other debates about how to create a well-functioning society and economy. Some of you will go into public or nonprofit service, and others will become entrepreneurs, but we will keep in touch to hear how you are innovating to improve your own life and to create opportunity for others. This past year, I've heard many inspirational stories of individual resilience among our students who have optimistically looked for opportunity in the pandemic. All of you gained new communication skills this past year. No one is ever going to question your digital literacy after living through this. Others have faced the historic disruption with empathy and compassion. For example, even while homebound, Paige Smith, who's a fast-track student, found a way to help others by volunteering for the CompuDoc Telethon, connecting needy Texans with laptops so they could work or learn from home and not fall behind. Other students took in neighbors without power or water, delivered hot meals to friends during our deep freeze, or donated to the Comet Cupboard, like the Criminology Graduate Student Association. Our resilient students, with their problem-solving skills, collaborative approaches, and compassion, will lead us into a better future. Leave us as proud Comets today, but please come back to campus soon. When you do, don't forget to rub Cecil Green's head for good luck and see how Love Jack has been relocated in the mall just outside of Green Hall. Whoosh.
William Adkins. Catherine Alexander. Massa Al-Mufti. Catherine Alvarez. Alyssa Amon. Bashra Amous. Angelica Avila. Leonard Ayala. Mirza Baig. Iman Bangesh. Radhika Bhakta. Michaela Callahan. Tanner Kennedy. Justin Cowell. Justin Chong. Theophilus Chia. Jinyoung Chung. Allison Clay. Caitlin Colby. Benjamin Crouch. Paul Cruz. Caleb Culver. Devin Dupree. Trevor Elrod. Hoda El Safadi. Osama Faridi. Cameron Four. Charles Foster. Senque Garza. Daniel Gavin. Sharon George. Alexia Gonzalez. Nathan Gonzalez. Jack Gruel. Arlene Jima. Samina Hanif. Matthew Hedeus. Yordi Herrera. Madison Hill. Rachel Howell. Connie Quinn. Antoine Jean. Mian Jimmy Jiang. Nelson Jiang. Bethany Kospatrik. Ragya Paul. Kennedy Kennerson. Aisha Kalf. Minchul Kim. Jeremiah Kincaid. Kristen Carolise Kolb. Venkat Kota. Isabella Lanzante. Tanner Lewis. Kendall Lincoln. Cassandra Lizardi Morales. Robert Lowe. David Luters. Ryan Marks. Paxton McCullough. Charles McCurdy. Matthew McElroy. Justin McManus. Leslie Medina. Maite Mejia Barrera. Navia Mehta. Samantha Mila. Somitri Miriala. Salam Mizu. Alexis Monroy. Matthew Mercewick. John Newton. Nicole Norman. Juan Olivo. Caitlin O'Malley. Anjana Parashar. Sravan Patel. Nicholas Pedroza. Elisa Perez. Anand Prasothaman. Carla Ramazan. Daisy Ramirez. Chetan Reddy. Lily Regalado. Jeremy Reiner. Mohammed Rizvi. Brian Osvaldo Rodriguez. Sophia Rogilio. Luz Rojas. Madison Rushing. Sarah Sachak. Jesse Sanchez. Sylvia Sanchez. Miguel Santiago. Anna Schaefer. Jessica Schell. Alexander Schultz. Ian Siemens. Cameron Shaw. Zane Shaw. Arupa Sharma Podial. Isa Shoganol. Christian Smith. Paige Smith. Julia Sokolowski. Shawnee Stadig. David Stewart. Jaslyn Stewart. Janae Stewart Jenkins. Brennan Stout. Brianna Thomas. Jade Thuna. Nguyen Tran. Nishant Tyagi. Roma Venkates Warren. Lauren Wallace. Jermaya Younger. Michelle Zamora. Michael Zink. Shiraz Zubi. David Amsler. Morgan Bartley. Aisha Bilal. Jocelyn Brady. Rachel Brazier. Azucena Briones. Holly Bryant. Marco Antonio Campos. Tiffany Cho. Arian Davis. Saba Edney. Mark Feldman. Federico Ferrero. Charlotte Ford. Megan Freeman. Kevin Fuchs. Jiao Gu. Elizabeth Hancock. Matthias Hudock. Manwan Kang. Humza Khan. Mohammed Ziad Mahmoud Karat. Young Hee Kim. Bonnie LeBeau. Samantha Manuel. Morgan McCoy. Elise Murby. Madison Nickerson. Graham Owen. Jennifer Padrone. Proma Paromita. Trevor Putman. Kelly Richards. Philip Roth. Shruti Sinha. Kevin Stassen. Salam Tasfamariam. Caleb Thibodeau. Annabelle Vega. Yuming Wang. Jacob Watkins. Paulina White. Che Jung Yen. Jiung Yuan. Abdullah Furkan Zengin. Miriam Ahmadi. Ogu Sultan Arizgeldieva. Mercedes Kalenas. Luis Fernando Colunga Ramos. Min Yu Han. Christine Millard. Mohammed Zishan Noor. Brent Sackett. Doree Stocks. Shahreen Upoma. Valerie Womack. Hanil Yim.
In the live commencement ceremony, I would now ask you to stand for one last assignment, the act of moving your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left. Now that you are graduates, your tassel will always be worn on the left, aligned with your heart. I also ask you to turn your class ring so that it faces away from you, to point outward, towards your future, symbolically pointing to your place in the larger world of UT Dallas alumni. This day marks a wonderful milestone, not only in your lives, but also in the life of the university. I wish you all the best as you go into your new lives as graduates of the University of Texas at Dallas. Enjoy your celebration with your family and friends, and please return to us soon. And now, please enjoy a performance of the UT Dallas alma mater. Whoosh.